In this problem, we're given the mass of a load being lifted upward by a crane. And this is a pretty aggressive crane operator because the load is actually accelerating upward with a magnitude of 1.8 meters per second squared. What we're asked for in the problem is the tension in the cable required to cause this acceleration. And we're reminded that we can use the approximation g is 9.8 meters per second squared for the calculations. So like all dynamics problems, the starting point is a good force diagram. So we see two vertical forces acting on this load, and those are the tension pointing upward and the force of gravity pointing downward. And we've already used the fact that the force of gravity is given by mg. Note that I intentionally showed the tension as a longer vector than the force of gravity, and this is because we know the tension must be a larger force, so that the net force points upward and we get an upward acceleration. Now we can get into the force analysis, and that means we want to write down Newton's second law. And Newton's second law says that F net is equal to ma. Now this really is a vector equation, but when we're dealing with a one-dimensional problem, we can use signs to keep track of direction. So we're going to call upward positive and downward negative. This means F net can be written as T minus mg, and that's going to be equal to ma. Now all we have to do is solve for T, and we find that T is equal to mg plus ma, and we can factor an m out of this to get a nice symbolic solution for T. So it's m times the quantity, g plus a. All that's left for us to do now is plug in the numbers. So we have our 1500 kilogram mass. We're using the approximation that g is 9.8 meters per second squared. And we were told that our upward acceleration is 1.8 meters per second squared. Now when I run the numbers on this to three significant digits, I get 17,400. And note that the units there are going to be kilogram meters per second squared, but that's just in newtons. So we end up with 17,400 newtons. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.